just to the video, not worry about it.
So today, we're going to be spending some time talking about hockey.
Oh, God.
I'm not going to hit it with anybody. But who would like hockey? Anybody like hockey? Anybody watch hockey? Kind of, sort of. When I was your guys' age, hockey was probably my favorite sport because it was the only sport I was only good at. So, basketball, I wasn't that great at. Football, I wasn't that great at. Baseball, I was all right at. But hockey, I remember playing hockey in gym in school, and I wasn't on the ice like they are in that video or like they do professionally. But I was running all up and down that gym floor, and I was like really good back in the day. No, it wasn't slippery, it was just a gymnasium floor. But all my classmates were like, he's too good, so maybe I should have gotten into hockey professionally. But I did not do that. But that is why it was one of my favorite sports when I was a kid. But I want to talk to you guys about something that hockey players do, because it's important. And football players do this too, baseball players do this, basketball players do this. But since we've already talked about basketball and football and baseball, we're going to spend some time talking about hockey. Hockey players have all kinds of protective clothes on. Did you guys see how they were all suited up like that? They had things for their knees because the ice is slippery, right? So if they fall, if they slip and fall, they want to make sure they have something on their knees.
Why do they do it on the ice though?
I don't know. Because
it's slippery and it's easy to do.
It's more competitive.
Well, it's more competitive sound that way. But they also have, what kind of shoes do they have on? Do they have regular tennis shoes on?
Ice skates.
They have ice skates, right? They have special shoes. What else do they have? What else did you notice that they had in that
helmets?
Video? Helmets, yeah.
I realized one guy had a cut.
They get a little cut up sometimes. But they also have they have padding on underneath for jerseys. The same thing like football players do.
And they don't care.
How they have shoulder pads and all this protective stuff on. So it's important for hockey players.
I'm not trying to get kidnapped.
Right, yeah. I feel like if we wanted to play hockey, we'd have to wear helmets, right? Because we don't want a puck. Like, this is what a puck is. That's that little black thing.
It's hard.
It will hurt if it comes into your face. So these hockey players, the football players, the baseball players, the basketball players, they come ready to play. They come dressed ready to play their game. Like, if a hockey player went on the ice and was wearing clothes like this, was wearing jeans and a shirt and a hat, would he be ready to play?
No.
No. Right?
First,
he wouldn't be protected, right? So, we know that we have an enemy. We talked about that a couple weeks ago. But did you know there are things that the Bible says that we need to put on to protect ourselves?
The Bible.
The Bible is a weapon, but I'm referring to the armor of God. The armor of God. And I'm sure some of you guys have heard
this. I was just about to say a chest plate.
This is the armor of God. And we're going to look at this little video and kind of brief, and we're going to talk about for a little bit more after video, talk about what the armor of God is.
The armor of God.
Yes. Oh,
man. I thought your voice was actually on TV.
The armor of God. God gives you the belt of truth to live God's word every day. You can know what's true and what's a lie, the enemy would say. He gives you the breastplate of righteousness to make you strong. God helps you to do what's right and stay away from what's wrong. The shoes of peace remind you that God is in control. Even when you're overwhelmed, you know God is over all. The shield of faith protects you from the enemy's attacks. With the shield of faith, you know that God has got your back. The helmet of salvation keeps your mind from fear. When you feel afraid, you can know God is near. And the sword of the Spirit is the Bible, God's special book. So open up the Bible and take a good long look. Be strong in the Lord and in His mighty power. Stand firm, be brave. God's giving you His armor.
So God has given us His armor. He's given a, and it's not, obviously we don't have, it's like an invisible armor. It's an invisible armor. Because we are in a war, we're in a fight, we're in a fight against the devil and the demons, right? So if we, now if you guys have seen movies about people going to battle or war, they have protection, right? Just like the hockey players do, just like we just talked about. So it's important to have protection. So I'm going to need a volunteer. Alexander, you want to dress up? Alright, so I'm gonna need a balance here. Let me see, who am I gonna use? Dude, you wanna come up here? I'll need you for something else a little bit.
Ready?
So, Duke, you just stand there for me, alright?
Hopefully he doesn't.
So, who is paying attention? What did they talk about the shoes? Well, let's talk about Duke's shoes for a minute. Those are some cool shoes, man. What did they say about the shoes? Who is paying attention to the video? Yes.
About the peace.
Yeah, we're called the shoes of peace, or and we can use that for God's peace. Now, so he's got shoes on, right? Duke's got shoes on. What was another thing that they talked about? Lindsay?
A belt.
A belt? Okay, yeah. Duke, you got a belt on?
Belt of truth.
No. The belt of what was it again for me? Anthony?
Truth.
The belt of truth. I don't have, I mean, this is a world championship belt. This isn't really going to, this is, we're just going to have to pretend, okay? Can you pretend with me? Put your arms up for me. Very good. All right, we'll just put this bad boy on. Now we got a belt for you. Now, the belt of truth, what did they say about the truth? Why is telling the truth important?
It's going to slip off.
It is going to slip off. It's a very big belt. But why is the truth important? Who can help me out? Why is telling the truth important? Lindsay? Let me see. Andrew, why is telling the truth important?
So you don't break trust.
So you don't break trust, okay? Anthony?
Basically, if you tell the truth, it's not, like, it's better to tell the truth because, like, if you don't tell the truth and the other person finds
just
out,
like that,
you won't have the best time.
Yeah, that's right. So, we got the shoes. The shoes are a piece about the truth. What other kind of things?
Sword.
What other kind of things?
Sword of spirit.
A shield. Let me get you a shield. Here, Duke. Let me get you a shield. We need a shield. You're absolutely right. Because we, like I just said, we are in a
fight.
That's
the shield that they have, though. Yeah,
so, we are in a fight because the devil, how many of you guys know the devil is mean, right?
Yeah.
Do you guys think the devil is mean or is he nice?
Mean.
He's mean.
Oh, can I shoot?
Right?
Ooh! Can I shoot?
Definitely.
Yes.
So the shield is used because when the devil tries to attack us, the shield of faith.
Back up
for me, dude. The shield of faith. Let me get you a different one. This is why I brought a different one. Of course, this one just locked, so let me see. There it is. You just gotta push back. The shield of faith is there to protect us. Keep your shield up. Keep your shield up. He's got more. The shield of faith.
Don't hit me.
Is there to protect us from the devil's enemies. To keep from his fiery darts is what the Bible talks about. So all the devil's attacks.
Ah!
Oh man, you should have your shield up. So
I'm done.
So
Oh,
I wanna do that one now since they just hit me in my leg.
Come here, help me out, get your shield up, because the devil doesn't. Because the devil doesn't stop, just keep on going.
Don't
just pull
me
that green finger.
Yo, both shoot me now. I'm not about to get shot in the leg.
You gotta keep your shield up. Here, we gotta hurry up. We gotta go a little bit faster.
Don't shoot me in the leg.
Because I have a game if we have time for it.
Shoot one.
We'll see. Maybe I'll let you shoot one later.
Don't shoot me.
All right. So we know.
Are you crazy?
There's one more in there. All right, good job. All right. Give your Nerf guns back to.
Last one.
Nope, give your Nerf guns back to Andrew.
Ah!
Give your Nerf guns back to
don't
Andrew.
Don't shoot me.
Give your Nerf guns back to Andrew. All right, so so Duke has a shield. That's why shields are important. That's why shields are important to protect us from the devil. What else does he need?
A sword.
We'll talk about. Get to that in a minute. What is something? What's missing right here? What's missing?
Staff.
What do you say, Anthony?
Chest plate. Chester.
Staff.
No, you need Chester. Plate. Yeah.
This is a really big chest plate. This is gonna make you look like you have some real big muscles. Put your arm through.
This guy got a 2-pack.
He's got a 6-pack.
Here, let me move your shield. There you go.
Look at that boy.
All right, pull
that boy got a 6-pack.
But chest plate is important because what's this? What's in our chest? Our hearts, right? So in war they use a chest plate like this because they don't want anything to get into their heart. That's why it's important.
We're gonna burn in fire.
I know. That's why it's important to guard our hearts.
You're gonna burn me down.
No. It's why it's important to guard our hearts, protect our hearts. That's why we have a breastplate. Now, Duke is looking pretty good. He's looking pretty fierce, but we need something for his head. We need something for his head. Here you go.
What is this?
That's a helmet. And the helmet is important because the helmet protects what?
Take a picture.
What's in our head?
Take pictures.
What's in our head?
No.
What kind of things are in our head? Hey guys, what's in our head? What's that thing that helps us think?
A brain,
right? And see, what the devil tries to do is he tries to put lies in our head. Dude, just hold it for me. He tries to put lies in our head. He tries to come at us and tell us lies, and makes us think bad thoughts. So that's why we need some head protection. And then finally, like you guys said. He needs a sword. Now, what is the sword of the spirit? Who can help me out? What is the sword of the spirit? What is it called? Do you guys know?
Hey!
Do you guys know? Look at Duke. He's looking pretty fierce. Can we give Duke a hand clap? Duke, you can start taking your armor off. Thank you, Duke, for helping me out. You look tough. You look tough and ready to fight. So, take your belt off. Take your belt off. You guys, I'm going to have a seat. So the sword.
Hey, Anthony, stop.
So we have the belt of truth, which is to help us take the truth, which is the Bible is full of truth. So if we read our Bible and we memorize our memory verses, we'll know truth. And then we have the shield of faith to protect ourselves against the devil enemies, the breastplate of righteousness to guard our heart, the helmet of salvation to guard our minds. The shoes of peace to help us walk in peace and love each other. And the sword of the Spirit, boys and girls, which is the Bible. Because the helmet, the breastplate, the shield, the belt, and the sandals or the shoes are all things to help you protect yourself. But you need something to fight back with, right? If you were in a fight or if you were in a battle, what good would it do to just stand there?
You get beat up,
you would lose. Let's say if hockey players just came into a game and they had all their protective padding on, they had all the clothes on, they were wearing all the right things, but they didn't have their weapon, which is their stick, to help them win, they wouldn't get very far, would they?
No.
You can have all, you need all the protective padding.
They could use it.
They could. But you would need something to go on the offense to fight back. And that's why we have the Bible. That's why, boys and girls, I'm always trying to get you guys to memorize what the Bible says. Because when the devil comes to mess with you, and to pick on you, and to fill your head with flies and bad thoughts, or maybe he's just being a big, fat, poopy pants bully like he is. That's what he is. You can have your shield of faith, what you need, but you also need something to fight back with. And that's the Bible. So when you memorize these memory verses that I gave you guys, I didn't really have a memory verse, we're talking about a whole bunch of things. We're talking about a big section of the Bible. But that's why I give you guys these. So that when the devil comes and puts lies into your head, or messes with you, you can say, devil, just be quiet, you big poopy pants jerk face, because I know what the Bible says. Because I know what the Bible says. This, the Bible, is the best weapon. Yeah, you need the rest of this. You need something to protect your mind and heart. You need a weapon to defend yourself. You need to tell the truth and walk in peace. But you also need to fight back. And can you talk to them a little bit more about fighting back as I go back here for a minute?
Austin,
I think
me?
Yeah, really quick. Austin, I don't
want to
go outside.
We're gonna go outside.
Yes, in just a minute.
What
are
we
gonna
do?
We have candles.
Austin,
you forget that
candle.
Just
talk.
Hurry up.
Whoa, that landed. I need all of you to be quiet. And I'll have to talk to you after class. Okay? You're not in trouble, but I still need to talk to you. Tell me how your summers are going.
Good, good.
Good. We were in a hotel other than getting a sunburn.
Best vacation this summer. Go.
Going to a hotel?
Going to a hotel? Actually, you're not in school yet, are you?
Yes, yes, she is.
She is?
You're already in school?
Yeah, she's in kindergarten.
All right, no, go.
Kindergarten. I mean, first.
Wait, what did you say?
What's one thing that you want, or, never mind. One thing.
Having no bullies.
Having no bullies?
No bullies. No girls not getting out. Please, no.
Well, you already have a girlfriend. I do.
Sorry.
You, some, what, one of the girls,
Okay, I don't need to hear this. I don't need to hear that. And do what answer was?
No teacher.
No teacher?
No teacher.
Yay!
Teacher?
Yeah.
No teacher!
I don't like my teacher.
You have a teacher for school.
Well, I like
that'd
teachers.
Be the best.
That's the best part.
Alright, we have one more thing we're gonna show you.
What?
Oh!
Ah!
Oh!
Ah!
take as many people with him as possible. He wants to kill, steal, and destroy.
That is what the verse that Andrew just said about the thief coming to steal, kill, and destroy. It's right here in John 10:10, Jesus talking. It says, the thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. And then Jesus says, I have come, but they may have life and have it to the full. So like Andrew just said, that's the devil's goal. He knows he has a short amount of time.
And guess what? You guys pass all the... Everybody that's here and loves Jesus right now, the devil hates us. Mm-hmm. Hates our guts.
The people that are on the devil's team, he loves them.
Well, he laughs at them because he deceives them and he tells lies to them. And the people don't believe his lies.
He's happy that they believe them.
He is happy that these people are believing his lies, again, to take as many people as possible, because he knows that he has a shortened time to take the people to hell with him before it's all over. And Jesus and God and heaven is going to be on earth one day after all this. All the big battle comes when the rapture, they come out, every the believers raise up to heaven, and then believe it or not, devil has full control of the world for a tiny little bit. And then that's when us, Jesus and God, will be riding on horses with all the angels and Jesus and God charging at the devil and his demons to battle it out, and then the devil's going to be thrown into hell forever and ever, and then heaven will come to earth, and we will be living with Jesus and God on earth. Does everybody get that?
Yes. At first,
well, we kind of went a little long, but the point is this is a God thing, because obviously God wants you to know that you guys are in a fight. I didn't plan on going this long. I really didn't. But obviously, boys and girls, you guys are here because God wanted you to know there's a fight going on. And he wants you to know about it. And for people who aren't here today, you can go and tell them, listen, this is what we learned about on Wednesday night. We need to suit up. We need to make sure we wear this armor and protect ourselves, because the devil's coming to get us. He won't, because we have Jesus living inside of us, but he's going to try. We need to be ready to fight. Let's pray. Father God, I thank you for tonight. I thank you for these boys and girls, and as me and Andrew have told them about this war that we are in. God, I thank you for your armor that you have given us, as that video said, to protect us. God, I pray for these boys and girls and for myself and Andrew, but we will stand in our armor. We will suit up and be alert, like we talked about a couple weeks ago, and be ready to fight against our opponent, our enemy. And for the ones who aren't here tonight, Father God, just use these boys and girls to talk to them on Sunday or whenever they see them next, and let them know that they need this armor. But we all need to spend more time reading the Bible and using the weapon that you've given us to. Because like we saw in that little video skit, we can slam a devil on the back with your word. Help us have a great rest of our week. In Jesus' name, amen.